Post Archive Faction, PAF, PAF, have a collaboration with On Running. I've not really liked On Running, and I've got to be honest, my hate for On Running has been for the people that I've seen wearing On Running shoes. Similar to, I think, to Metcons. I think if you're a hater of CrossFit, the thing that you hate the most probably is seeing people with Metcons on, who kind of act like they're athletes. They kind of act like they're going to the fucking CrossFit Opens. It's fucking lame. And when you see people wearing On Running shoes, they walk around as if like they've just come back from a marathon or from like a 10K, and really they've just gone to a local shop to go buy some fucking groceries. So I think On Running, I've had an issue with them, mostly because the people wearing them are flipping lame. But I have to be honest, this collaboration, this post-archive faction collaboration with On Running is really fucking cool. Really fucking cool. So obviously you got the clothing and you got the shoe itself. Looks really cool. I'm not really a fan of like lifestyle running shit. I feel like a lot of the lifestyle streetwear aesthetic running stuff is a bit lame, because most people that wear running clothes go out to run. They don't go out to stunt. It just feels a bit R-worded to kind of try and mix the both of them and try and make running to be a subculture or a genre. It's just a bit lame. Make performance wear that obviously looks cool that you can wear, and it's not going to make you look like you're legitimately running a marathon, and it kind of maybe looks a bit more relaxed. But the idea of, you know, people going out wearing this type of shit is kind of lame to me. But it is really cool. The clothes look amazing. The lookbook makes you want to buy them instantly. You have these amazing pants with this huge, huge zip on the side that almost allows the pants to kind of flare out. As you guys know, with PAF, they have this weird cut where they kind of cut the seams around the leg. So when the zip opens, it kind of makes the pant itself spread around the shoes. So you have this weird quasi boot cut, slim cut type of cut going on in the trousers, if you kind of get what I mean. So they look really fucking amazing, obviously. You've got loads of perforation hits here around the pocket to help with the, with the air and whatnot going in and out of your body as you're sweating and shit. You've got these really nice colors. You got these really nice leggings, really nice tops, and just a lookbook that kind of makes you want to run, makes you want to jump and run around, get active and wear this shit, right? It looks fucking fantastic. I'd wear everything in here. You've also got this amazing, I don't know what this is all about, by the way, you got this cool hood type thing. I'm not sure if this is pumped up, but on this picture here, which is picture number seven, you've got this amazing hood inside of the jacket. It looks like it's inflatable. That's kind of wrapped around the runner's head. It looks pretty cool. You got the sleeves on the jacket that kind of go over your finger, which I really like. So when you're running, obviously you got the paneling there. You got the fucking zip on the side of the trousers. Again, the trousers, tailoring wise, when it comes to post archive faction, they always make incredible pants and tracksuits and shit. Very underrated in that respect. Same goes for this look here. I love the undershirt here. I love the paneling. Love the little perforation hits and the little air gaps in there, so you don't sweat too much. The nice materialing as well looks fucking great. We love it all. Again, great picture. And it features models who look like they actually run as well. Nice form there, running on his balls of his toes. And obviously he's heel slapping his bum. But the best thing about this collaboration isn't the clothes. It's definitely the shoes. Look at these fucking shoes. These are allegedly, I think they're called like Cloudburst. No. I think they're called Cloudmaster 2's. So it's a collaboration with PAF. And they've taken the On Running silhouette and they've kind of skewed it to make it look like a footscape. So from the top, look at how it looks. From the top, it kind of has this weird type of, almost twisted eyes stay, eyelet type of design. So when you tie them up, I think there's actually a picture here somewhere. When you tie them up, they kind of almost look, I think I should get them on here actually from the Street Night News. You'll see a picture of somebody actually wearing them. They look fucking cool when they're actually on. So that picture of them actually from the top here looks like that. But then when somebody's actually wearing them, look what they look like. When they've got a bit of wear on them, courtesy of Street Night News. Look at that. So when you wear them, they kind of have this weird kind of like splayed rounded design. You've got this amazing big area here in the front that's almost mixed with mesh. I don't know what else material's on there. And of course the laces kind of make the shoe kind of fold within itself. Like, I think that just looks like a really cool design. So you can't really see it too tough on this particular picture, but you can definitely see it on this picture where they've kind of been worn in. So these Cloudmasters are fucking hard. I love them. I definitely wear the fuck out of these. So you got the On Running thing there. You got the nice tread at the bottom. They're also available in the all black colorway. And it looked fucking fantastic. So far, no date on release. I think the last thing I saw was like end of May. but we haven't got a concrete date yet when they're going to be releasing. But these are definitely some of the hardest on running shoes I've seen. And again, I'm a big hater of on running, but I think these are really fucking cool. I'm not gonna lie, I really fucking like these. So big up on running again. No date on release just yet. It says here, stay tuned for updates as we expect both Cloudmaster 2 colorways to land on shelves in the weeks to come. The price tag is going to be $250. Again, we've got some images here from the, I guess, the activation or studio or showroom event that they had in Paris, featuring some of the post-archive faction stuff with the on-running collaboration. Nice screens. You've got all the collections available there on the racks. I wonder if they got the shoes actually worn. That's actually cool. I quite like that, actually. This is a picture of the studio that the showroom, I guess, where they're showing off the collaboration. They have a rack full of the On Running and PAF shoes and clothes. And at the bottom, they have the shoes. And from what I can see looking from this far, it looks like both shoes have been worn. I like that they're showing what they look like when they're worn and stuff. I quite like that in running shoes. I think when it's running shoes, I think having the shoes look brand new kind of defeats the purpose of running shoes, because you're gonna fucking beat them. So I quite like that they have the shoes there worn at the bottom. It kind of looks cool, I'm not going to lie. So I actually would love to get a pair of these, I'm not gonna lie. These look really fucking cool, and I kind of like how the top of them kind of reminds me of a footscape. Not sure if you guys are familiar with footscapes, but that top of the shoe kind of reminds me of a Nike footscape. So it's got a Nike footscape type of design at the top, which makes sense considering these guys are, you know, Asian dudes with, you know, pristine, immense knowledge of fucking shoes and sneakers and stuff from back in the day. But that top bit kind of reminds me of a footscape. Not too sure if you guys see the vision here, but this kind of reminds me a little bit of a footscape design on the on the front or the top of the shoe. Where's the top? Let me see if I can find top. Yeah, there's a top kind of here. You can kind of see on the footscape woven, it's kind of got that almost like twisted splayed kind of thing. But I like how the actual eyelets or the actual, you know, where the laces are kind of being tied up here, they're actually not that twisted. It's actually this section here that makes them look like it's warped. This section here around the front that kind of gives this interesting shape here that kind of makes it look twisted. But the actual laces themselves are kind of dead center, but they do remind me a lot of footscapes and woven ones, especially with the kind of laces on the side. So I kind of like that, I'm not going to lie, I really do like that. So big up on running. I'll definitely try and get a pair for myself. 245 is a bit pricey, don't get me wrong, for running shoes, or 240 exactly, but I think these are probably worth it, especially considering the collaboration and the level of quality you're probably going to get from these. So big up on running, big up Blood Clot on running. We love to see it. We definitely love to see it.